Let us gather together. Every morning, the world is created anew. Under the orange sticks of the sun, the heaped ashes of the night turn into leaves again.
And fasten themselves to the high branches, and the palms here like black cloth, on which are painted islands of summer lilies.
If it is your nature to be happy, you will swim away along the soft trails for hours, your imagination alighting everywhere.
And if your spirit carries with it the form that is heavier than the head, if it's all you can do to keep on trudging.
There is still somewhere deep within you a beast shouting that the earth is exactly what it wanted.
Each pond with its blazing lilies is a prayer heard and answered lavishly every morning.
Whether or not you have ever dared to be happy, whether or not you have ever dared to pray, there is in each of us a trace of animal being calling for the earth. It is more than home. It is past and future, sustenance and security, cradle of life and comfort in death. There is nothing more natural than our connection with the earth, our call to the earth. May we hear it crying out to us, too. May we hear its pleas for relief from overconsumption, its appeal for good stewardship, its petition for care. May we, all of us, do what we can to heal our home and ensure the future of our human family and all other creatures. Celebrate the earth, not just in song, poem, and prayer, but in actions of hope and justice. Happy Earth Day. We join our voices now in the prayer Jesus taught us, saying, Our Mother, who art in heaven,
to New England Congregational Church on this beautiful fourth Sunday in the season of Easter. And a very special welcome to those who are guests with us today. Please take a moment and note your attendance in the Friendship Register. Join us following the service in the Narthex for coffee and treats and conversation. Do take a moment to read through the announcements in your bulletin. Of special note, today we will be sharing the one great hour of sharing offering of the United Church of Christ. This special offering channels resources for international programs in health, education and agricultural development, emergency relief, refugee ministries, and both international and domestic disaster response. To donate, please use the special envelopes and box in the narthex, or donate online via our website or the brand new QR code in your bulletin. Also today, our Social and Racial Justice Committee will host an Earth Day program on environmental justice following this service. Join them upstairs in Friendship Hall to learn how certain communities in our nation and around the world are disproportionately affected by pollution and global warming, and how we can help. Coffee and refreshments will be served. Lastly, Guy's Night Out will be this Thursday evening at Fireside Grill in Sugar Grove, beginning at 6 p.m. We'll have a delicious meal and a great time. Please sign up in the marketplace to join us. And now remember that no matter who you are or where you are on your journey of faith and life, you are very welcome in this place. Please greet your neighbors as our children come forward. Good morning. Thank you both for coming this morning. We're a little light on our children's time crowd, aren't we, today? But it is so good to see both of you, and you're brave. You're brave for getting up here in front of all these folks. Thank you. We are going to be celebrating something tomorrow as a nation and also around the world. Do you know what we're celebrating? Earth Day. It is Earth Day because you read it on your calendar. That is exactly right. We're going to be celebrating Earth Day. On Earth Day, we take time to be grateful for our beautiful planet and to think about how we can all work together to keep it that way for generations to come. What are some things you can think of we can do to help take care of the Earth? Yeah. Sure, maybe by cutting our use of fuels and gas, definitely. Yes, by putting trash where it belongs and recycling, definitely. What else, anything? Yes, for sure, we can recycle. There's a bunch of good things that we can do. Today, I wanted to share one of my favorite books with you. It's called The Earth Book, and it will help us think a little bit more about things that we can do to help care for our planet. I love the pictures, so I hope you will too. I take care of the Earth because I know I can do little things every day to make a big difference. I use both sides of the paper. That's a good idea, isn't it? Yeah. And I bring my own bags to the market because I love the trees and I want the owls to have a place to live. Those are pretty good reasons, right? I turn off the faucet while I brush my teeth and I use less water for my bath because I love the fish and I want the oceans to stay blue. Yeah, we don't like green water or brown water or no. You have. I take the school bus and I ride my bike every day because I love the stars and I want the air to be clear so I can see them sparkle. I try to eat every bite on my plate and save my leftovers because I love watching things grow, and I want there to be enough food for everyone. I remember to turn off the lights and shut the refrigerator to save energy, because I love polar bears, and I want the Earth to stay cool. Do you love polar bears? Yeah, they're pretty cool. except when they're trying to eat us. Those are good reasons to be less excited. I throw garbage in the trash, and I recycle glass, aluminum, paper, and plastic. Because I love to walk barefoot in the grass. Do you guys like that?
It hurts.
It hurts? Okay. Kinda. That's fair. Well, I love to walk barefoot in the grass, and I don't want to move to Mars. Most of all, I help take care of the Earth because I want us all to be happy and healthy. Every one of us can help protect the Earth and make it feel good. Remember, if we take care of it, it will take care of us. So this little book has a nice list of things we can do, 10 things I can help for the Earth. Number one, turn off the lights. Number two, recycle. Number three, save my leftovers. Number four, be nice to the worms. Number five, share a book. Six, plant a tree. Seven, use both sides of your paper. Eight, save water. Nine, clean up trash. 10, put your underwear in the freezer when it's hot. It said it. I didn't make that one up. But it's a fair question. It might help you stay cool. While none of us can do everything to care for the Earth, we can all do something, right? We can all do something. So this week, think about what you might do to help keep our planet healthy and beautiful. Let's have a prayer before you head to Kid Zone. Dear God, we're so grateful for this amazing planet Earth. May we take extra good care of it so that it stays healthy and beautiful for generations to come. Amen. Thank you both for being here. Let us be together now in a spirit of prayer. The psalmist writes, "O sing a new song, all the earth. Let the heavens be glad and let the earth rejoice. Let the sea roar and all that fills it. Let the field exult and everything in it. Then shall all the trees of the forest sing for joy." May we learn to pause a moment to hear them sing and join their refrain. May we learn to hear lament as well as joy. May we learn to hear petition and respond with action. God, even as the cosmos itself joins in a great symphony of the spheres, may our voices add harmony and richness, even counterpoint, but never dissonance. For the ways that we clash with creation destroy its sweetness and silence its song, may we repent. For the ways that abuse and overconsumption threaten the delicate balance, endanger species, and put fellow human communities at risk, may we repent. For turning a blind eye and a deaf ear to suffering and sorrow that humans cause and have the power to prevent, may we repent. May we learn to hear and to sing a new song, a glad song, a full and complex song, a joyful song, in harmony with all that is. Amen. a reading from Scripture. First, the Gospel according to John. Jesus said, "I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, who is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. The hired hand runs away because a hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me, just as God knows me and I know God, and I lay down my life for the sheep." Reading now from the Epistle of John. We know love by this, that he laid down his life for us. And we ought to lay down our lives for one another. How does God's love abide in anyone who has the world's goods and sees a brother or sister in need and yet refuses to help? Little children, let us love, not in word or speech, but in truth and action. Here end the readings. Most of us know the little nursery rhyme, "Mary had a little lamb." Raise your hands if you know this. Great, let us unite our voices and say it together. Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow, and everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go. Well done. We all graduated kindergarten. I recently learned that this nursery rhyme, which was first published in 1830, is based on an actual incident involving Mary Elizabeth Sawyer, a woman born in 1806 on a farm in Sterling, Massachusetts. In 1815, Mary, then 9 years old, was helping her father with farm chores when they discovered a sickly newborn lamb in the sheep pen. It had been abandoned by its mother. After a lot of pleading, Mary was allowed to keep the animal, although her father didn't hold out much hope for its survival. Against the odds, Mary managed to nurse the lamb back to health. In the morning, much to my girlish delight, it could stand. And from that time, it improved rapidly. It soon learned to drink milk, and from the time it would walk about, it would follow me anywhere, if only I called it. Mary would later write in the 1880s, many decades after the incident. And yes, the lamb would indeed follow her wherever she went, and did have fleece as white as snow. Sometime later, it's uncertain exactly when, Mary was heading to school with her brother when the lamb began following them. The siblings apparently weren't trying very hard to prevent the lamb from tagging along, even hauling it over a large stone fence they had to cross to get to Redstone School, the one-room schoolhouse they attended. Once there, Mary secreted her pet under her desk and covered it with a blanket. But when Mary was called to the front of the class to recite her lessons, the lamb popped out of its hiding place, and much to Mary's chagrin and to the merriment of her classmates, came loping down the aisle after her. The lamb was shooed out, where it waited outside until Mary took it home during lunch. The next day, John Rulston, a student just a year or two older, handed Mary a piece of paper with a poem that he'd written about the previous day's events. It's kind of a sweet story, isn't it? And it's true. And there are like three more verses to the poem, so I'm glad we didn't try to say those as well. Mary's lamb even grew up, and it had three lambs of its own. Beginning with a text about the good shepherd laying down their life for the sheep, you probably wondered if this little lamb story would have a happy ending. Did anyone wonder?
I wondered.
Yeah, some honest folks here. We wondered. Truth is, we rarely know where things will go until we actually get there. Believe it or not, it has been 3 years since we began our relationship together as minister and congregation. My very first sermon after arriving in Aurora in 2021 was on Good Shepherd Sunday. At that point, I'm fairly sure that we were all wondering where things would go from here. I know I was, and it looked a little different with only 20 people in the entire building. 3 years ago, I encouraged us to be shepherds to one another and to live like the Good Shepherd for the sake of our world. Today, though, I'd like to warn us from taking that directive too far. You see, for the author of the Gospel according to John, Jesus, the Good Shepherd, was inarguably destined to lay down his life for the sheep. We, however, are not. Elucidating and expanding on this text, the author of the Epistle of 1 John clarifies what this means for us. Yes, Jesus laid down his life for the sheep, and we should do likewise, but what does that look like? For the author of 1 John, it looks like seeing someone in need and helping them. It looks like living our love, not just in words, but in truth and action. Laying down our life does not mean offering ourselves up as the ultimate sacrifice. Laying down our life does not mean dying for others. It means living for others. And in some cases, that is even harder. What are we willing to live for? A partner? Children? A career? A cause? A life of service? What are we willing to pour ourselves into day after day? What are we willing to get out of bed for? It may not be just one thing. For the author of 1 John, it was a guiding principle. Love lived in truth and action. But I think it's a worthwhile question for us to consider. What are we willing to live for? Little Mary Elizabeth Sawyer lived for her lamb, at least for a while, nursing it to health, teaching it to drink from a bottle, encouraging it to walk with her and get stronger. Laying down one's life for the sheep is a noble sentiment. It's certainly how the author of John's Gospel interpreted the events of Jesus' life. But the author of 1 John challenges us to lay down our lives and then to pick them up again, to be lived in service of love expressed in truth and action toward others. Today, on the eve of Earth Day, one might take the epistle's author a little bit further in their challenge to live truth in love and action for the sake of others and the earth. After all, working towards sustainable living and a healthy planet would be a worthwhile labor of love in action. Future generations will certainly look back with gratitude. But whatever it is we decide we're living for, Marcus Aurelius reminds us that it is not death one should fear, but rather never beginning to live. Amen.
The healing of the earth, the oneness of all life, and a peaceful coexistence together, we dedicate our church, our gifts, and ourselves. Make it so. Amen.
Thank you.
And now, dear friends, let us go forth to live love in truth and action. And may the love of God, the friendship of Jesus, and the peace of God's Spirit bless and keep you all now and forever. Amen.